The Tragedy of Macbeth. Hell yeah. I saw this movie at the New York Film Festival, where at first I was indifferent with it, but then I got to attend the one-day-only IMAX screening, in which my opinion changed significantly. Is it one of my favorites of the year? No, but this is genuinely a great movie. And if you ever get the chance, if this chance ever comes up again, please, I am begging you, see this in IMAX. From a visual standpoint, there's very few out there like this, especially for a Shakespeare adaptation. As someone who's not a fan of Shakespeare, it's so refreshing to finally see a Shakespeare adaptation where the tone actually fits perfectly. This is an incredibly dark, slow, claustrophobic film. And that's kind of what Macbeth is. There's a certain way you need to tackle it, and it's clear that Joel Coen knew exactly what he was doing and how to do it. These sets, these costumes, the sound design, the 1.33:1 aspect ratio, is all pretty seamless. But if I had to describe the movie as a whole, I would say it has the vibes of an old horror film from the 1930s. Weird comparison coming your way, but the sets in particular reminded me of something like 1931's Dracula. It's extremely effective and helps set the tone perfectly. There are certain shots and certain sets and even the use of lighting that are incredibly unnerving. I feel like I'm watching something I'm not really supposed to see. The performances are fantastic, as you'd expect. This is an all-star cast, and they're giving it their all. Denzel Washington is amazing as usual as Macbeth, delivering Shakespearean dialogue in a way that makes it hard to look away. Frances McDormand is equally as great, but it's Catherine Hunter as the witches who is absolutely impeccable. Her performance is an all-timer. She's not in it much, but every time she's on, you can't take your eyes off. The best way I can describe her is imagine a modern-day Lon Chaney performance. Her looks, her acrobatics, her voice, it's so unsettling. It's god-tier. If there's anything I had to complain about, it's mainly due to the fact that it seems like you have to really like Shakespeare in order to fully appreciate this. A lot of the dialogue is pretty incomprehensible, and I can see a lot of people being bored by this movie, unfortunately. It doesn't really add much new to the Macbeth story. It very much relies on the filmmaking and performances, which are spot on, but Shakespeare can only be so interesting for so long, you know? Overall, The Tragedy of Macbeth is pretty great. It's not one of my favorites of the year as of now, but it's one that I do see myself revisiting a lot. It's a true love letter to Shakespeare, and it's one of the better adaptations we've got. Check it out if you want.
And that's the end.